These six things will blow your mind as to how important they are for hair growth. But somehow, so many people do not talk about these six practices whenever they're talking about the red hair women's secret to growing long, shiny, black hair. Meanwhile, maybe these six practices are the real reason why their hair is so long and shiny, not even the rice water. Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we're going to be talking about the red hair women of China. Now, if you don't know who these women are, they are a group of women who are known for having extremely long hair, and somehow they credit this long hair to rice water. So if you've happened to use rice water before because of how trendy it was, then bear in mind this rice water thing originated from the red hair women of China. So that out of the way, I'm going to be giving you guys six other things the red hair women do to grow their hair longer aside the rice water. The first practice the red hair women do to grow their hair longer and shinier is they comb their hair every morning. Now looking at it, it just seems like it's just combing your hair every morning. There's no big deal to that. But technically, they comb their hair every morning with a wooden comb. Now, this is going to help evenly distribute the sebum that the scalp produces throughout the length of their hair to protect their hair and prevent it from breaking. Also, this is some sort of scalp massage that helps stimulate blood flow to their scalp and nourishes their hair follicles and hence promote healthy hair growth. So guys, though combing your hair every morning might look like a very small detail to pay attention to, the red hair women may know the benefits of this, hence they do this every morning, guys. So if you also like to use this method to grow your hair out, then this is how you can do it for our hair type, because as you know, we don't have straight hair, so we cannot comb our hair out every morning. We're going to cause more damage to our hair in the course of doing that. So if you have type 4 hair and you like to practice this daily scalp massage like the Yao women do, then all you have to do is use your fingers to do that, not a comb, so you don't damage your hair in the process. So you just have to wake up every morning and just massage your scalp as you pull down the sebum from your scalp very gently towards the length of your hair. Now, our hair is so dry because it's curly and there is no way for the sebum that our hair produces to find its way towards the end of our hair naturally, hence why we experience a lot of breakage and we have to learn how to moisturize our hair ourselves. That being said, the next thing the red hair women do to grow their hair longer and shinier over the years is they wash their hair in the inversion method. Now, you don't know what the inversion method is, but I'm going to show you guys what it is. So it's simply bending over. I think I've already shown you guys in one of my videos on my wash day routines. I'm going to insert the video here. You can go check how I do that. But it's simply bending your head over, then you massage your scalp. So every time the red hair women want to wash their hair, they do the inversion method and then they massage their scalp as they rinse off the rice water from their hair. Now they do this 3 times a week, so you can see they technically do the inversion method and scalp massages 3 times a week, which is already proven to help grow hair longer and thicker. So maybe the rice water is not even the real reason why their hair is growing so long, but practices like this one will actually help anybody's hair grow longer. So one way you can incorporate this into your routine is whenever you're washing your hair, you can just bend over and do the inversion method as you massage the shampoo or whatever thing it is you use to wash your hair, so you can start profiting from the benefits of some of these Yao women practices. The third thing the red Yao women do that we don't do on a regular basis that might be actually the reason why their hair is growing so long and so fast is they wash their hair in the river, guys. Yes, they wash their hair in the river. Now, this might look like a very simple thing to you, but the river has so many minerals in it that might actually be helping protect their hair and nourish their scalp, which in turn increases the possibility for them to grow their hair longer, thicker, and darker right up to their 80s. So now, I don't know how you can find river water wherever you are to incorporate into your routine, but when I'm going to be trying the rice water here on my channel, I'm going to look for some random river and carry water from there and use it on my hair. Yeah, I will do that. Now, the fourth thing the red hair women do that encourages hair growth for them is they cut their hair just once in their lifetime. Yes, guys, I know. Cutting your hair just once in your lifetime means you technically have accumulated hair growth for over 20, 40, 50, 60 years, guys. They cut their hair once they are 17 years old, and that's it. So women of 60 years in the Yao village have probably been growing their hair for over 30 years and above. So that is also one of the reasons why they have extremely long hair. Some of us were trying to grow our hair out, constantly cut our hair every single day. Though cutting your hair is a good thing because it eases manageability and makes your hair fuller and thicker, the red Yao women do not cut their hair at all. So after they've cut their hair at 17 years, they never cut their hair again. So that may be one of the reasons why their hair is so long. Now don't get me wrong, trimming your hair is actually good, but over trimming your hair will prevent your hair from growing that long if extremely long hair is your goal. The fun fact is the Yao women do not actually have thick hair all the way to the ends. They do have a bit of split ends though, but they don't care, so they just focus on the length of their hair and that's it. Also, all the hair on the Yao women's head does not belong to them. So once you're a mother and your daughter is up to 17 years, you're going to cut her hair and you add it to your own hair. So most of them, half of the hair you see on their head does not belong to them. So you have to note that and don't have unrealistic goals when doing the rice water challenge or whatever it is you want to use rice water for. And the fifth thing that encourages the hair growth of the Yao women is they do not manipulate their hair a lot. So once they wash their hair, they're just going to wrap it in this very simple low manipulation hairstyle. And that's it till the next morning, where they're going to comb it and just tie it back up like that. So maybe if you're looking to have extremely long hair, you want to learn to reduce manipulation in your hair and try practicing very simple hairstyles that do not add tension to your hair or anything of the sort. Also, the red Yao women don't use scrunchies nor bands to tie their hair. They use their own hair to tie their hair, so they don't have anything constantly catching pieces of their hair and breaking it off. So you can add that to your routine as well. Bonus tip as to why the red Yao women's hair might be growing extremely long and healthy right up to their 80s is they live in a very natural environment. They have little or no pollution. They eat healthy, most likely because of their environment. They hardly have processed food like us in other parts of the world. So this might actually be the reason why their hair keeps growing healthy and dark. They breathe pure air, they eat healthy food, they wash their hair with clean purified water straight from wherever it's coming from. They don't use so many chemicals and tools in their hair. They simply have their wooden comb and their rice water as product for their hair. So their hair care routine alongside their environment might just be the thing encouraging their hair to grow so fast and healthy, given that they constantly eat healthy, breathe healthy, and have healthy hair care practices with no chemicals involved. So now that we have explained the six things the red Yao women do to grow their hair longer, it's time for us to dive into the recipe itself. Now, their rice water recipe is very different from the recipe we see all the time online. So if you like to find out the authentic and real way to make the red Yao rice water, then make sure to watch this video right here, because I'm going to be making the rice water for you all to see how they make it and exactly everything they put in it, including the secret ingredients. So thank you guys for watching the video to the end. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share my video. Also, if you've not yet joined my Edge with Growth series, make sure to check out that video right here as well.